reeking of fuel here as well, because there was a spillage on the forecourt. I'll be stopping part way on the trip here to see how much foul this is used. At least once. Hoping the smell of petrol goes away, because if it doesn't, we might have some problem. Around my feet, that's what it's off. So we're standing in a pool of it. radio and it's too noisy. Raising the speed limit to 80 miles an hour on these roads, and now doing just under 70. See the wind farm up in front of us or not? Windmills twirling round on the hill to the right. Altogether. It just looks as if it's the same farm from here. Or it did anyway. You should see it separately now, that's the one there. I don't know where that one is. Obviously not with all the others. So I get a distinct impression this car is getting too warm, the engine. Watching the temperature gauge, there's a smell of something warm. Something warm. temperature's gone down on the temperature gauge. I still smell something warm. Says 50. stop in this little lay-by here and break the cast. Oh, it's got redesigned. It wasn't this big last time I stopped here. That's nice. So I'm stopping the recording here, I'm going to restart it. And the next stopping will be when we come off the motorway at the other end. Assuming we can get back on the road, that is. And a little chef next to each other, and that's unusual. that's Pendle Hill. Not the best angle to see it from. And he looks smaller than last time I came with him. Can't be, but he just looks it. At this junction, so I'll stay in this lane. Yeah, that's Pendle straight ahead of us. To me, because I've not been here for such a long time. So, and this is the motorway I once drove on in blinding rain coming the other way. Absolutely blinding rain it was. Shares in a company up here, but they went bust. Bionic Industries, they were called. I think the factory's gone as well then. Can't see it. Just been looked at by a camera there. I don't know what sort of camera it is, but it's just looked at us. Degrees, by the way, here now. See the empty gasometer grid there on the right? That was used to be full of gas. doesn't look like it's used now. It's very rusty. I used to keep them in better condition than that. Being filmed as well, causing a major traffic jam. Oh my god, look at that traffic jam. Somebody's filming a wedding car. It's a big wedding. And who that is? Probably a footballer. And I bet they got married at Cone Parish Church because it's the oldest one in the area, I think. Let's try some music. We're coming up to the end of the M65 and Boundary Mill. You should see Cone Parish Church and Town Hall very shortly. Past this bridge, I think. Towers the parish church and the spiky one is the town hall. And Boundary Mill is to the right. In fact, it's got its own signpost. In fact, we'll go through Cone and let you have a look at it. hiking than walking in this temperature. Now this is the old A56. And that church is where I first came across Clitheroe Parish Church Organ Society. The chap was inaugurating a new organ in there. You can see the old railway viaduct ahead. The station is just the other side of the viaduct, and that's where the track ends at the moment. Road used to be worse than it is now. It used to be a really sharp bend here. There's another railway bridge. Better known hotels in the area, the Crown. We're now looking up Albert Road. No prizes for guessing who it's named after. Yes, you're right, Prince Albert, that one. Queen Victoria's consort. Wasn't too good a plan coming up here. That's a good plan at all. Well, we can get through down there, so there's no point in turning left. Left here is the library with a memorial to Wallace Hartley in the Titanic. And that building there is the Co-op. Really big building. The post office, as was. It's still is, I think. See the town hall with a flag on the top now. Nearly. Britannia Building Society, that's my building society, the one I first ever joined, and I'm still with them. It used to be called the Colne Building Society. This is New Market Street. There used to be a record shop down here somewhere. Colne is built on a hill, and you can see just how steep the hill is. We've missed the parish church, but at least we've avoided some of the jam. We've probably found there's one down here now. That's a well sorted out golf there. KFC. There's a shop I sometimes go to, the Massillon. And the McDonald's next to the KFC. I think we'd have been better staying in the main street. We've hit another traffic jam. I don't know why there should be one down here. I really don't. left last time I came along here. That's gone as well. Sainsbury's. Oh, well, wow. That's new to me. And last time I came here, this wasn't a roundabout. Called the North Valley Road. Now, I don't know where that fisherman's going. I don't. Speed sign with a smiley face. Well, that's different. The cast here again. I won't stop there very long because this is a bus stop.
Sorry about that, folks. No, I was distracted by something in Frank's channel regarding a person being an absolute prat in Frank's channel. Okay, it's not Frozenly, it's Run Out. Okay, you can probably guess who the prat I'm referring to in Frank's channel is, because at least one of you has had problems with this certain prat in question. I'm sure you know who I mean. Exactly, that particular prat. Yes, you're quite correct. If he's in this channel now, UFC, you're a prat, full stop. The donkey is something to do with US politics, actually. There's a donkey and there's another animal, which is the other party. I'm not sure which is which. One of the parties is a donkey and the other one's an elephant. That's the one, yeah. Yeah. So, is the elephant the Republicans and the donkey is the other lot, right? Oh, it wasn't politics that we were discussing. It wasn't politics we were discussing at all, it was something else. The first thing he comes in, when the UFC comes in, he makes a snide comment about me every single bloody time. Anyway, here's the next party. Next foul. Hang on a minute. This one goes from Heffer Lane, where you stopped at the, where you were stopped at just a moment ago. It goes to White Collar itself, I think it does. Anyway, this is the one. Okay,
now this is leading into the Forest of Throne, which is where I used to live. This is called Heffer Lane. More than one way to get to White Collar, which is where we're going, but I'm going to go through the village, or through on the main road. My dad used to work for this firm in front of us, well, in the building in front of us, not the firm. This is Cotton Tree, and the fish and chip shop's still open. Post office isn't. There used to be a mill on the left here. No longer. And I used to live up this little side road here, Gladstone Terrace. I'm not going to go up there now, for obvious reasons. Those trees by the road, I planted those. All of them. They should have been taken out years ago, in fact. To knock the wall down. To be a mill there, in fact there still is. And on the left, in a moment or two, there's a mill called the Black Car Mill, which is where my mother used to work in one of her many jobs. It used to have three storage sections, but there's only two left now. Cottage Cookies, Biscuit Makers. There was another three-story section there, and part of the mill's gone. There was a mill on the left as well, another one where she used to work at. Now, this is the road to Wycoller. These buildings were built by Bannisters, the mill firm. Still in use, but the Rock Business Centre. A friend of my mum's used to live in this terrace here. See, these roads are not really designed for heavy traffic. Anybody can do more than 30 miles an hour up here is welcome to it. And this used to be a blind corner, and they've managed to clear it out a bit. Left is a recreation ground. Now you can imagine in winter when it snows, these roads fill up with snow and they're completely impassable. A nasty feeling Wycoller is going to be rather full, which is not what I intended to, but we'll soon find out. For sale, track two for sale. Ahem. Trust me to pick one of the busiest days of the year. Okay, we're on the car park in the village, and the reason why there's a car park out here is because the village is very small, and if all these cars went into the village it would be absolutely impossible. So I'm going to stop the recording for now and pack up and walk into the village itself. Okay.
Okay folks, you're obviously going now. I'm not going to continue any further with this one, but there are actually already highlights of the of the visit to the park already in the files on here, and I'll be splitting this one up into three to highlight this later on. I'm sorry I can't talk very much because I've got a sore throat which keeps firing off on me. Well, I'm not staying for a few hours now. It's 16 minutes past 12. It's time I was thinking about getting to bed. So I'll shut off the cast now. Has it been reasonably good quality, Andy? Okay, right, okay Fizzy, right. So anyway, I think I'm not going to be using XSplit for broadcasting live on the move at all now because of the sound problem. I use it like this with the recorded sound. It also gives a better picture as well, I think. So the XSplit Live will be in the house only, and on the road it'll be like this. The live on the road will probably be on the Patrick Murphy channel instead, using the other FME transmission instead of this one, because this doesn't seem to work properly. I've also got some more memory coming for the other laptop. Well, Fizzy, yeah, the trouble is the microphone's on top of the camera, and if you put a windsock over the microphone it covers the end of the camera as well, so you can't see then, if you know what I mean. That's the problem with it. And it's sometimes when it's very, very little wind as well, as hardly any at all. And yet it sounds horrible. I'll try and improve it. I've got some foam somewhere, I'll try that on it, but I can't guarantee it'll make any difference. It really annoys me, does that, but that's the only problem. I mean, I think you're listening to me on the microphone now on the camera, as far as I know. It sounds as if this is going on. It sounds as if you're doing that all the time. Can you hear a noise at the microphone? You should be able to. Did you hear that noise then? That was me rubbing my finger on the microphone. George Baker. No. Yeah, it would be loud, yeah. George Baker, now, that doesn't, name doesn't ring a bell. Wexford. Is that one of the police things? Inspector or something? Right. Anyway, enough of that. It's time I was... I'm going to have some cocoa, I think, now. I'm going to go back over to Frank's channel and see if FCU is still there. FC UK. I've actually put him on ignore, so I won't see his comments, but Migraine chipped in as well, didn't she? So that got me slightly even more irritated, because he... I don't know. At least Frank didn't blame me for it anyway, that's one thing. Okay, guys, so let's lose this. Yeah, indeed she does. Now then, let's see, I'm logging out now, so I'm going to disappear now.